The following is a sports presentation of the University of Nebraska's radio station, your home of continuous coverage of the Nebraska Cornhuskers, 90.3 KRNU, Lincoln, Nebraska.
Scott Frost, the quarterback of tonight's winning Nebraska Huskers. What a game. Just describe the feeling at this point and also your thoughts on the national championship picture.
Well, it feels great. I'm so proud of this team, and I'm just so proud to have had a chance to play for Coach Osborne. And I just want to say this about the national championship. You know, if I don't think there's anybody out there that with a clear conscience can say that Nebraska, and especially Tom Osborne, that great man, doesn't deserve a national championship for this. At least a share.
I'm coming home. I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming home.
Getting ready for the second overtime period, and amongst reports, multiple reports, now saying that Scott Frost will be named the next head coach at the University of Nebraska.
But guys, some big breaking news in the world of the Big Ten. Brett McMurphy is reporting that Scott Frost has agreed to a 7-year, $35 million.
It gives me a great deal of pleasure at this time to introduce the 30th head football coach at the University of Nebraska, Scott Frost.
Felt so strong. I'm Zach Penrice for Husker Countdown. College football is back in Lincoln, Nebraska, but more importantly, Scott Frost is back. It wasn't so long ago that Husker fans were clamoring that he'd be the next man to lead this storied program, and they got their wish. Now all that's left to see is what the 43-year-old former quarterback can do in control of the program that built him into what he is today.
Words can't describe how much it means to me to be back here in a place that I love, a place that I understand, a place that I want to represent. People here are passionate, and nobody knows that better than me. And we're looking forward to tapping into that the right way. And watching this program from afar, I don't think people have been unified in support behind something for a while.
A lot of what Frost has said since arriving in Lincoln back in December has had a lot to do with bringing Nebraska back to its former glory. It was Frost who quarterbacked the Huskers to their third national title in 4 years, 21 years ago in 1997. In his eyes, the recipe that worked so well for the mid-90s teams has drifted into the past, and it's his goal to bring that back to a Nebraska fan base that is desperate for a championship.
When I was here under Coach Osborne, there was unity of purpose and unity of belief and unity of understanding and unity of support for this program, what it stood for, and what it was accomplishing. This program needs that again. This state needs that again.
Since Frost finished his collegiate career with the Huskers, he has spent 6 years in the NFL and his last 15 years coaching. He's worked at Kansas State, Northern Iowa, Oregon, and got his first head coaching job with the University of Central Florida. UCF was a winless team the year before Frost arrived, and it only took him 2 years to take that program and turn them into an undefeated 13-0 squad. Because of that immense success shown by the former Husker QB and new leadership at Nebraska, the timing for Frost's return could not be better.
I'm thrilled to be back because I think the time is right for this. And it wasn't always that way. But with Hank and Ronnie and Bill, I think the leadership is right. I think the time is right. I think the state is hungry for unity.
A familiar face, a winning recipe, and timing. Everything on paper looks good. Of course, the most important test is still to come. Tonight, the Huskers host the Akron Zips, a team out of the Mid-American Conference that finished 7-7 in 2017.
Akron was they're a good team. They were in the MAC championship last year. I think their coaches do a really good job. I think there's good schemes on both sides. I know their return. I've watched their defense more, and they're returning, I think, 9 starters on defense from a team that helped them get to their league's championship. Expect them to come in ready to play. So we have to be at our best, and like I said, we have to execute well and take care of the football.
The Huskers head coach has talked a lot about bringing Nebraska back to the way it was, After all, it was Frost that led the 1997 team to a national title. Of course, we won't know how similar 2018 will be to that season, but there is one striking similarity already, besides Frost being back on the Nebraska sideline. The 1997 Week 1 opponent, Akron. The stage is set, the lights are on. It's game day in Lincoln, Nebraska. A new era for one of the nation's most storied football programs starts tonight. The waiting is over. Husker Countdown starts right now.
Chance to return this one. He does from his own 2-yard line, coming back across the 10 to the 15, 20. Spielman's got a hole across the 35 to the 40, 45, 50. Spielman might go 40, 35, 30, 20, 15, 10, 5. JD Spielman, 98 yards to the house. No flags, just like that. The Huskers are back on top.
Pass is going to be caught for a touchdown by Nebraska by Jack Stoll, the tight end.
Throws it in the end zone. Touchdown, Huskers. JD Spielman with the reception, and the Huskers put 6 on the board.
Handoff over left guard. Ozigbo plunges into the end zone. Husker lead. It's 9-7.
Hornibrook sets his feet. Still looking. Dances. Out boundary. Pass intercepted. It's by Aaron Williams. It's a pick 6 in the Nebraska Lancers. Return the favor against Wisconsin. It's a 12-yard INT return for points, and the Huskers are a point away from a tie game.
Broadcasting live from Memorial Stadium in Lincoln, Nebraska, 90.3 KRNU proudly presents Husker Countdown. Got an angel on my shoulder.